this encapsulates a certain period in Russia that you just don't get from textbooks. You know, there's nothing more powerful than the artist painting what's going on in the world around him. And the fact that artists are seen to be as powerful as soldiers, you know, with their paintbrush, sort of using a visual type of propaganda, that's it, especially when most of the population were illiterate, you know, it's through the visual arts that a message is passed. Most of it is propaganda. You know, even when you see paintings of Lenin and Stalin and they're stood there in front of red fabric, you know, everything, even though magnificent paintings as they are, they're sort of researched back through the Renaissance and how those great masters would have painted, but it's trying to propel them and put them up on a pedestal, making them holier than thou. I mean, don't forget some of the icons were reproduced of these leaders to replace Jesus Christ.
There was a group called the Association of Russian Revolutionary Artists. They were villainously determined to kill off the avant-garde. insults, Okhachev, fierce, ferocious criticism. And they became more powerful as the 20s went on and became a source of socialist realism. And they argued very strongly that people needed to be able to understand the art. Ordinary people, people on the bus, needed to be able to know what on earth it was all about. And they couldn't do that with Popover or Kandinsky, not surprisingly.